स्टैंडर्ड 4 सब्जेक्ट एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज पार्ट 1 एंड द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज लेसन नंबर 17 माय अपब्रिंगिंग। लुक एट द पिक्चर्स केयरफुली। व्हाट डू यू सी? इन द फर्स्ट पिक्चर वी सी अ ग्रैंडमदर टेलिंग स्टोरीज टू हर ग्रैंडचिल्ड्रन। In the second picture, we see the father and the son are giving bath to an animal. In the third picture, we can see the father teaching his daughter how to ride a bicycle. In the fourth picture, we see the daughter watching her mother how she is cooking. In the fifth picture, we see the mother and the son brushing teeth together. There are many different things happening in these pictures. And there are children learning from the grown-ups, that is, from the elders and people around them. Because of this, they learn many things, some likes and dislikes. This lesson is all about upbringing. Now, what is upbringing? Upbringing is nothing but the different things that we learn as we grow up. They help us to develop and form certain habits, likes and dislikes. We learn these habits from our parents, relatives, friends, and neighbors. We learn many different things while we are growing up. They lead to the development of certain habits, likes, and dislikes. They shape our views and thoughts. This is what is known as our upbringing. You must have seen photographs of your childhood. You began to crawl. You learned how to walk and how to talk. And apart from this, you learned many more things like how to brush your teeth, how to bathe, how to eat without spilling, how to behave with people older than you. You learned many more things besides these basic ones. How to fill your school bag, how to ride a bicycle, how to play a cell phone game, when to feed the cattle, how to buy groceries, how to behave with strangers. The list can go on and on. How did you learn all these things? Who taught you all these things? You must have learned many of these things from your parents and relatives. Holding our hand, our parents teach us to walk. They teach us how to behave and how to talk to others. When we make mistakes, they show us how to correct them because they want us to become good people. Do you know how does a lion cub learn how to hunt? A lion cub is not able to hunt as soon as it is born. It is taught how to hunt by its mother and other lionesses in the pride. Pride means a group of lions. These cubs are quite helpless for about the first 2 weeks. They do not even open their eyes. Therefore, their mother keeps them hidden away from others. When the cubs are about 8 weeks of age, they are introduced to the members of the pride. All the lionesses take care of the cubs. A cub is pampered by all of them until it is 3 months old. Then it begins to learn how to hunt. It takes 2 to 3 years for a cub to become adept at hunting, which means by 3 years of age, the cub learns how to hunt by itself. Our loved ones too try hard to see that we develop good habits. Our close relatives, like our grandparents, uncles, and aunts, also have great affection for us. We learn many things from them too. People who are close to us teach us how to carry out our own tasks ourselves. They appreciate it when we can do all these things properly. They commend us, saying that we have grown up. Do you know or have you heard the names Hali Raghunath Baraf or Sameep Anil Pandit? Hali Raghunath Baraf is a 15-year-old tribal girl from Shahapur Taluka in Thane district. Hali showed great courage and rescued her older sister from a leopard. Sameep Anil Pandit rescued 3 buffaloes tied in a cow shed from a fire. Like our loved ones praise and appreciate us when we do good things, even our country praises children when they do good deeds. For these brave acts, the two were felicitated with the National Bravery Award by Dr. Manmohan Singh, who was the Prime Minister of India in 2013. Do you know about the great worker Baba Amte? Muralidhar Devidas Amte, popularly known as Baba Amte, was born on 26 December 1914 in Hinganghat, Maharashtra. He was a lawyer and a social worker. Being a follower of Gandhi, he wore only khadi clothes woven in his ashram. Baba Amte spent his entire life in social service. His lifelong goal was to serve people suffering from leprosy and also other handicapped people. He helped them to stand on their own feet. He also founded the Anandavan Ashram, a rehabilitation center for leprosy patients. Baba Amte received a number of awards from the Government of India for his great work, the highest of them being the Padma Vibhushan in 1986. In this mission, he was helped immensely by his wife Sadhana Tai. His work and life was very influential. His sons and daughter-in-laws, who are medical doctors, they too have dedicated their lives to social service. Now, even the third generation of Amte's family is carrying on this mission. This is an example of social service carried on relentlessly by 3 generations of a family is really inspiring. Everything that we learn is not taught to us by somebody. We pick up many things through observation and through exposure. Like, how do our friends speak? What clothes do they wear? What games do they play? How do they study? We pick up many of these things unconsciously. Many times, we also begin to behave like our friends. Which means, sometime you learn some things unknowingly. Like for example, Your friends invite you to play with a top. You don't know how to spin the top, and yet you join them. You observe them spinning the top. Then you also try it for a few times. After trying for a few times, you also learn how to spin the top at perfection. You learned to spin the top not because somebody has taught you. It is because you observed your friends carefully. Let us learn with the help of one more example. These parents have come for a PTA meeting at school. See what they say to each other. Renuka's mother says, "Earlier, Renuka never ate her vegetables. Now that she has started going to school, she eats everything without a fuss." Zoya's mom says, "Ever since Zoya, Shilpa and Gail have become friends, they ride their bicycles together every evening. I'm happy that they all get enough exercise." Prathamesh's father has to say that ever since Prathamesh has become friends with Salman and Bowman, he has started taking a lot of interest in maths. In this example, the parents are telling each other that their children have learned something good from their friends in which they were never interested before. This teaches us that unknowingly we learn many things from our friends too. We are influenced by other people around us, just as we are influenced by our friends. We meet our neighbors every day for some reason or the other. We observe their ways of behaving, speech, and eating habits from up close. This too has an influence on our upbringing. If people from another place happen to be our neighbors, we naturally get to know about their food and festivals, which may be different from ours. This is how we become familiar with diversity. Many of our neighbors know us from our childhood. They too feel affectionate towards us. We learn some good habits from our neighbors too. Our neighbors also influence our upbringing. Let us understand with the help of few examples. Pratap says, "This is my neighbor. He likes to go for walks every morning. I call him Azoba. Sometimes I go to the hill with him." Supriya says, "Didi, living next to us, loves to read. She often gives me nice storybooks to read." Hina tells us that, "This is my neighbor. She is very old. Even then, she sweeps her front yard every day without fail. She does her own work herself. Because of her, I realized that we all must be self-reliant. Like Pratap, Hina and Supriya, we too learn many things from our neighbors." Now, let us take a quick recap of what we have learned today. The many things we learn as we grow up together make our upbringing. Our parents and close relatives play an important part in our upbringing. We also learn many things from our friends and neighbors. We learn from the conscious efforts taken to make us good people. We also learn through observation and exposure. I hope you have understood how our upbringing is influenced by our parents, relatives, friends, and neighbors, and how we learn many things knowingly and unknowingly from them. So children, I hope you have enjoyed watching the video. See you in the next week with a new video. Till then, take care of yourself and have a nice day. Thank you.